Hello, this is Book A Day, and today I'm going to be talking about Shadow Mystic, Book 4 of the Shadow Core series. I would call this barely a lit RPG, if only because the other books talked about it lightly. A lit RPG is a book based around an RPG engine, like you would see in a video game or a tabletop game. Okay, so we start off the book where they're in a time of kind of peace. There's still a way for the Great Deceivers to get through, and Hadrian's trying to figure out how to close it off. During this time, for some reason, Samantha and Dax start getting close. For what apparently seems like for no reason other than a romantic interest needs to happen. They start off with some light banter, a little bit of training, some more banter, some more training, some more intimate time spent with each other. That was not planned out. They find themselves in a almost romantic seeming grapple as Sam starts to feel things towards Dax that she wasn't thinking about throughout the entire series. And Hadrian walks in going, what are you guys doing? Now, from a reader's point, I kind of assumed that they're going to have some sort of romantic interest between Dax and Samantha when I read the first half of book one. But there was nothing to lead up to this throughout book one through three. The only reason why I felt like there might have been something there was just because of the specific description that was given to Dax in his introduction. If there is ever a relationship that looked any more forced in a book, it will be hard-pressed to try and beat this one. The story jumps from that to a couple of solo missions with Sam, where she starts building up the necessary inventory to make their final stand or stop against the Great Deceivers. One of which is collecting the dragon again, which was nowhere near as eventful as the third book. Hadrian explains to Samantha that there may be no coming back from this last mission, but it will stop the Great Deceivers by closing their portal or rift. I can't remember. I'm not gonna lie, this book was kind of boring. She uses the power of the dragon and Dax to help maintain her health, because Dax is a healer of sorts, and they go and shut the rift or portal. Unfortunately, due to the strain of power that it takes, Dax not only had to stand next to her and try to revive her as she's trying to close it, but he had to merge with her. Little weird, but we're going with this. In the merging, he became part of her, and they both get sucked into a pocket dimension that is nothing like the one in the, I believe it was the second book, where her powers are amplified, where she can manipulate anything that she wants in this pocket dimension. She finds that Dax is manifested physically in this pocket dimension, despite the fact he was merged to her body. And then they pronounce their love for each other, kind of. They spend an unspecified amount of time together before Dax is just lost to matter or whatever. He just disappears. And then Samantha is just there by herself for what could be a couple hundred years. Jumping to the more interesting side of the story, Napalm and Karma are getting ready to go back to his home planet to try and establish peace treaty with his people in order for them to help with the resistance against the Great Deceivers. They believe that's a possibility that they can get away with this because Napalm's father is no longer in charge. Little to their knowledge, not only are they accepting of them, but Napalm's sister that he had no idea about from his mother's side had came in and taken over claiming in his name. After this happens, we find out that she is half of what Napalm's race is and the other half a Dexaliciatite. Now, if you didn't read any of the other books, you should know by now that he is asexual. All Daxalicia types are asexual. So this conflict of interest, because she is half of both species and doesn't exactly follow by their rules. He challenges her to some sort of gauntlet affair where the winner takes the kingdom, and he wins. Long story short. Jumping back over to Samantha's problems, she finds herself in a situation where superheroes need her help to stop the Great Deceivers because apparently they didn't do it right in the first half of the book. Why? We are introduced to an unusual set of characters. Our lead captain of the group, I believe his name was Butch, and his harem. And they love sexual innuendos, like, ridiculously. They grab Samantha, talk her into helping them, and go off to save the universe again. Oh boy. This is leading up to what I believe is the official ending of this series. And thank God. The book got a bit new agey, which, if that's your thing, cool I guess. But for me, it always gets weird and uninteresting because new age stuff really just doesn't make sense sometimes. It was a much shorter book and looked like it could have been stretched out in a different direction, more like making this into a different series. Say take the first half of the book and putting that into the end of book 3 to give book 3 some more meat and potatoes, and creating a different series for book 4 that debatably might have been more interesting. As a whole, I want to give this book a 2.5 out of 5. It wasn't interesting to me. It didn't even try to grasp at any straws to Lit RPG. I think they mentioned the system once, and it was more of an afterthought than anything else. They do give some closure, like Dax comes back at the end, but it's kind of like, well, this is like a feel-good ending. Of course he's gonna come back. If you're expecting otherwise, then you gotta go read a different book. Alrighty, this has been Book A Day, and hope you guys have a good day. Bye-bye.